A very good evening to you. Thank you for joining us. Welcome to this midweek edition of Sports Tonight. Promises to be exciting, promises to be fun-filled, as always. I think in the spirit of the season, I should be starting off the show by wishing you the very best of this season.
And 30 degrees.
Just hope that this season will bring all the positivity and all the pleasantness that it can. For all of us. So it's a wonderful time to be here. I'm so happy to be with you on the show tonight. My name is Tony Ibitoye. I want to start off the show tonight by introducing to you my friend and partner. Together we'll be on this show for the first part, Onyewuchi Nwachukwu, news editor of Sporting Life, one of our best-selling sports dailies, is on the show with me tonight. Onyewuchi Nwachukwu, thank you for joining us on Sports Tonight. Welcome to the show this midweek.
Yeah, thank you so much.
It's a day that we should celebrate. This is the day that the Lord has made. Yeah. We should rejoice and be glad in it.
Yeah, when you look at the circumstances
under which we are able to qualify.
A lot of people wrote them off, you know, because of injury. Even before the injury, they had issues with the defensive frailties. But they've been able to, you know, overcome those obstacles. And they are true to the final. And they have also picked Rio Olympics tickets.
Which is the more important thing?
Last time we didn't qualify for Sydney Olympics, and even the performance at the qualifiers in Morocco was nothing to write home about, but I think CSI has done well. For me, I think he's a man of destiny.
All right, that will be one of the major issues that we'll be talking about on the program tonight. We will try to also hear from you. We will also be speaking to a former Nigeria Football Association Secretary General, Alhaji Sani Toro. We'll be speaking to him on the program tonight, and we will want to hear from him. Sani Toro was the NFF General Secretary in 1996, when Nigeria, for the first time, went to the Olympics and won Olympic gold. So we'll be hearing from him later on the show. We want him to speak to us. We want him to advise the Nigerian Football Federation on how they can adequately prepare this team, because now that the team has qualified for the Olympic Games, they are not just the property of the Nigerian Football Federation. The National Sports Commission also have a role to play. The Nigeria Olympic Committee also have a role to play in adequately preparing this team for the Olympic Games. So later on the show, in the next couple of minutes, we will try to hear from Alhaji Sani Toro from Bauchi, and then, of course, tap from his wealth of experience and knowledge on how we can adequately prepare our dream team or our Olympic team for Rio 2016. But before we do that, before we talk to Sani Toro on the program tonight, let me just give you an idea of what we'll be doing on the show. I already told you that a major part of the show will be the Olympic Eagles and what they've been able to achieve in Senegal today, beating the host and qualifying for the Olympic Games and also qualifying for the final of the CAF Under-23 Africa Cup of Nations. We will also, on the program tonight, be spending some time to take a look at domestic football. On the show on Monday, we talked about coaches who are moving from club. Club are hiring coaches. Club are firing coaches. Sunshine Stars looks like have settled for their man. They've got their man. Who is going to be the coach of Sunshine Stars, replacing Kennedy Boboye, who left at the end of last season? We'll find out on this show as well. We will also be filling you in with wrestling. Our wrestlers are not having the best of times. They were supposed to travel to Brazil for a wrestling championship to further prepare them for the Olympic Games. Looks like they won't be able to do that. We'll talk about it as well on the program later tonight. And of course, UEFA Champions League games are going on as we speak. Yesterday, we had plenty of drama. Some of the top teams, upsets everywhere. Today, games are also going on, and we will find out what the stories are around some of those results. Of course, you can trust us on Sports Tonight. As we go along, we will update you with the results from some of these venues as well. And tonight, on the program as well, we will be spending some time to talk beach soccer in Nigeria. And when you talk beach soccer in Nigeria, one event comes to mind, and that is Copa Lagos. It has become like the highlight of beach soccer in Nigeria. Hopefully, we should be getting the initiator of Copa Lagos, Samson Adamu, to be a guest on the program tonight. He's stuck in traffic at the moment, but I'm sure he will be able to make it down before the end of the show so that he comes to us on the show to tell us what to expect from beach soccer, from Copa Lagos, in a few weeks from now. Can Team Nigeria regain the trophy they lost last year? And what other things are going to be lined up for those who will want to enjoy the best of beach soccer this December? All of that we have for you on the program tonight. But let's tell you what role you have to play. And I think we really want you to play this role tonight. I know that there are distractions of UEFA Champions League matches going on all around us, but this is very key. You need to be a part of what we are doing on the program tonight because it concerns your team, the dream team, the Olympic Eagles, who have picked the ticket to the Olympic Games in Rio in 2016. You need to talk. You need to advise. You need to give your opinion. You need to give us your thoughts. You need to give us your ideas on how this team can do better. And, of course, equal the record of 1996. Interestingly, next year, it will be exactly 20 years that we won Olympic gold in Atlanta. Can we do it again? That should be the target for the Nigerian Football Federation and the National Sports Commission and the Nigeria Olympic Committee. All right, Oye, before we go on a quick break now, let me start with you. Olympic ticket in the bag. That's obviously not the end of the road. We can make it better on Saturday if we win the CAF Under 23 Championship. This is the second edition. The first edition, we didn't do well. We can make it better by becoming African champions at this level on Saturday.
Yeah, very, very true. True, Tony. You know, the second semi-final between Algeria and South Africa is currently, you know, being played. And I think the North Africans are leading 1-0. You know, whichever way it pans out, whether it's Algeria or South Africa, I think Siasia will add another feather to his cap if he's able to get this team to win the Under-23 CAF Nations.
The Algerians have scored a second goal. Yeah, they are leading 2-0 now. It's looking like Algeria are home and dry. Yeah. That's the result right there on your screen. Algeria are 2-0 up over South Africa.
And
I told you that our group,
very tough.
Was a tough group.
Yeah, very tough. And if he navigated his way through the match that was played today with a lot of injury worries, I think for the final, Azubike Okechukwu is captain.
Azubike Okechukwu, yes.
His captain will be, back.
Stanley Dingba could be back.
Stanley Dingba.
Taiwo Awoniyi could be back.
Yeah, Taiwo Awoniyi. So he has a lot of options. Mm. And that is a good omen for the team going towards the final. So, but more importantly, is for the players to also understand, you know, the importance of winning for the country. You know, I think in previous games, some of these players really let Samson Siasia down. We know we are aware of a lot of issues, but you know, when you put on the jersey of the national team, you put aside every issue,
become secondary.
Yes, and you know, play out your hearts. And I think that's what they actually did against the match they played against the whole Senegal today. So for me, they have a lot to play for against Algeria. It's looking more likely like Algeria in the final, because if you win, then the team and the coaches will have a bragging right. He is now left for the Football Federation and the entire country, you know, to show gratitude to them, you know, for weathering these obstacles. We've had a lot of issues, and we are still able to win that tournament. With so much injury, we learned that their bonuses have not been paid and all those things, and they still remain focused. And if they eventually win, then, I mean, the sky will be the limit for them.
What will you be advising? Whatever happens on Saturday is now secondary.
Yeah.
The most important thing is that these guys have a ticket to the Olympic Games, which was the motive of this tournament in the first place.
Absolutely.
Well, the icing on the cake will be for us to go and win it, which we hope these boys will do on Saturday. But what would you be advising, Coach Samson Siasia? For the Olympic Games, you now have more options.
Yeah.
You now have more time.
Yeah.
You now can call up a lot more of those foreign-based players. Is it going to be okay for us to try to break this team down and just begin afresh, or just look for a few problem areas and bring quality into those areas in this team instead of wholesale rebuilding of the team?
It will be counterproductive to, you know, throw away the baby with the bad water. I think there are some players in this team that got some good quality. Is it only trying to compare this team to the 96 squad? There's no reason for comparison, because before we went to the Olympics in 96,
Kano Nwankwo had already won the Champions League with Ajax Amsterdam. Remember, we won the Nations Cup with a lot of players.
And most of those boys had gone to the World Cup in 1994.
Austin Okocha,
African champions,
so
Sunday Olise.
So comparing is like asking too much from this team. But is it nothing is impossible when it comes to football. So what I think the advice is, CSR should remain focused. He has the opportunity of inviting three overage players, remember? Then the Olympic Games, obviously, will be held when the European calendars will be on break. So he has an opportunity to invite some, look at areas like the defensive options for him, get some quality players, retain some of the players that have distinguished themselves at this tournament, and we move on. But the key is you play more friendlies.
Adequate preparation.
And now, play a lot of friendlies.
I'm going to come to you on that. But let's go on a break. Now, my producer says we should take a quick break, bring you highlights of that game, Nigeria against Senegal. Everybody had written the Nigerian team off. And it's another lesson for every one of us. Never write off a Nigerian team. Never. Because it is when they are pushed to the wall that they show the quality.